Hello everyone, welcome to MBBS classes. Myself Dr. Hanifa. Today in this video I'll be talking on Pure Tone Audiometry, or commonly known as PTA. PTA, it belongs to the subjective test. The audiological test batteries, they are divided into subjective and objective. Among the subjective test, it is behavioral observation audiometry, tuning fork test, pure tone audiometry and speech audiometry. This video is only about pure tone audiometry. The objective tests of hearing are tympanometry, auditory brainstem response or ABR, and otoacoustic emissions. This pure tone audiometry, it is the most common audiological test for evaluating the hearing sensitivity of a person. When we do the test, the result is plotted on a graph called audiogram. So this is a picture of an audiogram showing the right and the left ear results, and the result is interpreted as following. This test is done using the auditory pure tone signals at frequencies ranging from 250 Hz to 8000 Hz. So if we see here, this pure tone audiometry, in the y-axis is the hearing level or the hearing thresholds, which is measured in terms of decibel HL, and in the x-axis it's plotted the different frequencies of the pure tones which is given to the particular ear. So we can see here it is 250, 500, 1K, 2000 Hz, 4000 Hz and 8000 Hz. So the pure tone signals are delivered in these frequencies, and the result is plotted on a graph called audiogram. So what is the hearing threshold? How it is measured? According to the American National Standards Institute, it defines the hearing threshold level as the minimum effective sound pressure level of an acoustic signal. Here it is pure tone, which produces an auditory sensation. The hearing thresholds is described as decibel HL or hearing threshold. So we can see here, whenever we look into an audiogram, in the x-axis, I repeat, is plotted the frequency of the pure tone signals. On the y-axis is the hearing threshold levels, which is, the unit is dB/HL. So in audiogram, there are different type of symbols. So we call it audiogram legions. These audiogram legions are the various symbols which are used to represent data for the ear and the bone conduction for right and the left ear. So always remember, right and left is written on the audiograms, but there is certain color coding also. All the legions of the right ear, they are red color, and the legions of the left ear, they are of blue color. So just let's see one by one. This red color circle, it signifies the air conduction that is unmasked. However, it is like a cross or X in the left ear. A triangle red color, it signifies the air conduction with masking, whereas it is a square in case of left ear. The bone conduction unmasked, respective ear, it is pointing to the respective sides in right with red color and in left with blue color, and it is a square box when the bone conduction is done with masking. This downward pointing arrow, it signifies no response. Sound field level, it stands for S, A is for sound field aided, and CI stands for cochlear implant. So before we understand an audiogram, we must know these audiogram legions. So there are certain prerequisites for the doing audiometry. There are certain specifications of room. The room where the audiometry is done, it should be double walled sound treated room as per ANSI specifications. Again, the earphones which are used for audiometry is color coded. For right ear, it is red color earphone, and for blue and for left ear, it is blue color. Patients are instructed to listen carefully to the presenting tones. and they are asked to respond either by pushing a button. So when they push a button, a flashlight is generated in the audiometer, and or they are asked to raise their hands. So this is how the testing is done. So this is a picture of an audiometer. These audiometer which is showing several color cables. If you look carefully, there is red color and blue color. Red is for right ear and blue is for left ear. Again, if you see this headphone, these are the bone vibrators. Again, the red color is for the right ear and the blue color is for the left ear. And when the patients, they give signal, then it is plotted like this on the chart and which is printed on a paper called audiogram. So the pure tone audiometry, it includes the measurement of both ear conduction and bone conduction hearing thresholds separately for right and the left ears. When we do the ear conduction hearing threshold testing, it means we are measuring the function of the total hearing system, including external ear, middle ear and the inner ear. For testing the ear conduction thresholds, pure tones ranging from 250 to 8000 Hz are presented to the ear by either headphones or the insert earphones. And the color coding should always be correct. The pure tones which are presented, they are initially above the threshold level up to 5 dB and then they are presented in the decreasing steps, that is 10 dB less than the threshold. The hearing level or the hearing threshold is the point at which a response is obtained 3 times. There are certain points to be considered when we are reading an audiogram and the ear conduction threshold level. So we have to remember that the ear conduction threshold level, it measures the hearing acuity of the entire system. But when it is interpreted alone, it provides very little information about the cause of hearing loss. These ear conduction hearing threshold should always be interpreted along with the bone conduction. Then only it will provide us with the information regarding the degree of hearing loss and about the type of hearing loss. We'll discuss this in details later on. When we are measuring the bone conduction hearing thresholds, for this, a bone conduction vibrator is held against the skull at the mastoid process, but sometimes on the forehead also. For this, the vibrations of frequency ranging from 250 to 4000 Hz is presented to the mastoid bone. What happens is that when the bone vibrator, it vibrates, it stimulates the cochlea. Thus, it bypasses the external ear and the middle ear. Since it bypasses the external and the middle ear, the bone conduction threshold, it gives an interpretation of the inner ear functioning. And it is the difference between the threshold of the ear and the bone conduction which helps us to determine the type of hearing loss, whether it is conductive hearing loss, sensorineural hearing loss, or mixed hearing loss. Moreover, the location of the bone conduction, it helps to determine the degree of hearing loss. So, after we do the assessment of ear conduction threshold, bone conduction threshold, the pure tone average is calculated as the average of hearing thresholds at frequencies of 500, 1000 and 2000 Hz. So in an audiogram, the result, they are divided into a normal hearing, conductive hearing loss, sensorineural hearing loss, and lastly, mixed hearing loss. Now let us see an audiogram of a normal hearing. Before we interpret an audiogram, we must know that the audiometers are calibrated in such a way that the AC and BC thresholds are less than 15 dB. That means whatever may be the result, that in a normal hearing, the AC and BC will always be less than 15 dB along the y-axis. And since here the ear conduction curve in circles, if we trace, the ear conduction threshold is within the 15 decibel range, and even the bone conduction in arrows, it is less than 15 decibel. So this is an audiogram of a normal hearing. Now, this is an audiogram of a conductive hearing loss. Now, how to know that it is a conductive hearing loss? For examining, first we have to trace the bone conduction curve. If we see here, the bone conduction curve is normal. That means it is within 15 dB threshold. So in conductive hearing loss, the bone conduction curve will be having the normal threshold. But if we see here, the ear conduction curve, ear conduction is this one. In circle, it is plotted. So this ear conduction hearing threshold is more than 15 decibel. And this is the bone curve, this is the ear conduction curve. And this gap is known as ear bone gap or AB gap. We call the audiogram as conductive hearing loss when the ear conduction thresholds, like in this audiogram, is elevated relative to the normal bone conduction threshold. And when the AB gap is more than 20 decibel, it is indicative of conductive loss. And the causes of conductive loss may lie in the external ear, middle ear. So there are various causes. The causes we are not discussing in this video. Now let us see the audiogram of a sensorineural hearing loss. For interpreting the audiogram, we have to look into the bone conduction threshold first. If we see here, the bone conduction threshold, here it is more than 15 decibel, that is, it is more than the normal. Here it is more than 20 decibel. And moreover, the ear conduction threshold in cross for the left ear. So how to know it is a left ear? Left ear is written here. This audiogram, it is in blue color. And this cross means the ear conduction unmasked for the left ear. So if we see here, the bone conduction is reduced and the ear conduction is also reduced. And there is AB gap is less than 15 decibel. So when the ear conduction and the bone conduction thresholds indicate the same level of hearing loss as in this audiogram, moreover, when the bone conduction threshold is more than 20 decibel, as we can see here, it is more than 20 decibel. And when the AB gap or the ear bone gap is less than 15 decibel or less, then the audiogram is called as sensorineural hearing loss. Now let us see the audiogram of a mixed hearing loss. We call the audiogram as a mixed hearing loss when the ear conduction thresholds are elevated. If we see here, the ear conduction thresholds of the left ear is again elevated. It is somewhere around 60 to 70 decibel. They are elevated relative to the abnormal bone conduction thresholds. Here, the bone conduction is also elevated. It is not in normal position. But here, the difference between the sensorineural and the mixed hearing loss is that the AB gap is more than 20 decibel. If you see, the bone conduction threshold is elevated, and moreover, there is an ear bone gap more than 20 decibel, then the loss is plotted as mixed hearing loss. Now let us see the degree of hearing loss. The degree of hearing loss is based on the hearing thresholds of the respective ear. So what is normal? Up to 25 dB, it is considered as normal. Mild loss is from 25 to 40 decibel. Moderate loss is from 40 to 55 decibel. Moderately severe is from 55 to 70 decibel. Severe loss is when it is between 70 to 90 decibel. And we call it as a profound loss when the loss is more than 90 decibel. So till now we have seen the audiograms of normal hearing, conductive hearing loss, sensorineural hearing loss, and mixed loss. Now let us see some special cases. So this is an audiogram of an otosclerosis ear. In otosclerosis, the stapes foot plate, it gets fixed. So There is certain peculiarity about the otosclerosis. It's that there is an increased hearing thresholds in the ear conduction. It is more at the lower frequency. If we see here, this is the upper curve, is the bone conduction, that is the square brackets towards the left side. And this cross is the ear conduction curve for the left ear. So if we see here at the lower frequencies, that means at around 250 to 1000 frequency, the threshold is increased more than in the higher frequency. Moreover, a notch is seen in otosclerosis, which is known as Cahat's notch. Cahat's notch is the notch in the bone conduction curve. Usually in otosclerosis, the bone conduction threshold is almost normal, but it shows a dip at 2 kilohertz. If you see here, this is a 2000 hertz or 2k hertz. When the bone conduction curve, it shows a dip at 2k, and when the ear conduction threshold is increased at lower frequency, it is characteristic of otosclerosis. Moreover, it is seen that the Cahat's notch, it disappears after successful stapedotomy. This is another interesting audiogram of noise-induced hearing loss. In otosclerosis, we get Cahat's notch, and in noise-induced hearing loss, we get audiometric noise notch. What's that? In early stages of post-noise exposure, the audiogram shows the notch reduction in sensitivity, which measures maximum between 3 to 6 kHz. In noise-induced hearing loss, the type of hearing loss is sensorineural hearing loss. So how it is sensorineural? If we see here, the AB gap is less than 15 decibel. And moreover, the frequencies which are involved in noise-induced hearing loss, it is from 3000 to 6000 Hz. And at 4K, generally, we see a dip. And if we see carefully, there is a recovery at 8 kHz as shown in the audiogram of both the ears. So audiometric notch is seen in NIHL. Now let us see the audiogram in a case of Meniere's disease, or it is also known as endolymphatic high drops. So in early stages of the Meniere's disease, the pattern of audiogram or the curve is different at different stages of disease. The rising type we get in the early stages of the disease. In the rising pattern, the audiogram shows sensorineural hearing loss in the lower frequency. So the uppermost curve, it is showing the sensorineural hearing loss in the lower frequency range. That is the rising type of curve. As the disease progresses, it gradually involves the middle frequency. If you see here, in the early stages, the middle frequency was normal. But as the disease advances, the middle frequency also gets involved and the graph becomes flat type. In the later part of the disease, when the hearing threshold increases for the higher frequency, then the pattern of the graph, it just reverses and it tends to become falling type. This is an audiogram of a condition known as presbyacusis or age-related sensorineural hearing loss. And I want to point out that presbyacusis is still the most common cause of hearing loss. So the audiogram in presbyacusis is typically sloping high frequency sensorineural hearing loss. If we see here, the bone threshold is more than the 20 decibel. And if we see here, the ear and the bone conduction gap is less than 15 decibel, which means it is a case of sensory neural hearing loss. What happens in presbyacusis is that typically it involves the higher frequencies. After 2K, if we see here, there is a sudden dip at 4 and 8000 K. So this type of falling pattern of sensorineural hearing loss is suggestive of presbyacusis. With this, I would like to conclude. Thank you for watching this video.